Good evening, everybody. Namaskar. Welcome to the Paradigm Shift. Today, we are in conversation with Venkat Raman Iyer, the fabulous, fabulous person, managing trustee of Swabhiman. And I'm not going to be telling you anything about him because we are going to hear it from the man himself. Welcome, Mr. Venkat. How are you?
Devshika, thank you so much for having me on the program. And thanks to all the viewers, too. It's a pleasure to be on your program, Devshika.
It's an honor to have you, and I'm so happy that you could take out time for us. This is beautiful. This is wonderful. So, so should we start at the very beginning? How did you know, like how you say that everything good starts in the early childhood? So how were these seeds sowed? Like, do you remember anything that happened in your childhood that led you to be the man that you are today?
So, Deepshika, I belong to Bombay. We had extremely humble beginnings. So, since you are a Bombayite, you will know what a chawl is. We actually lived in a chawl, me and my two brothers and parents, five of us in a chawl house that is about 300 square feet, as small as that. And as all chawls do, we also had these toilets and bathrooms outside the house. So, that's the kind of beginning that we had. But God has been extremely kind, Devshika. In spite of all odds, the one thing that our parents guaranteed was education. So we got good education and hence we were able to move on. Basically, I've had, in spite of the limitations in terms of benefits and other, you know, pleasures, we had an extremely happy childhood. People of those times, I'm sure, unlike the kids now, not that the kids now don't get happiness, but we got happiness out of nothing at all. Just being out there playing cricket, having fun, being going around the city, all of it. So I had an exceptionally happy, you know, childhood. But what changed my life? There are two incidences that changed my life. I was an absolutely normal human being, which I still am. sometime when I was in college, there was this movie that got released called The Gandhi. If you remember Richard Attenborough's movie, I was not a Gandhi until then. And I accidentally went and watched the movie. And I was so touched by the, you know, personality and the persona of Gandhi that I started to read up on him. That is the first time that I started to think of others, not just myself. Till then, I was thinking of my education, my career and all that. But after the movie too, though the imprint was made, I was not yet a person, you know, thinking for the others. I was lucky that, you know, I went to Middle East at a very young age. Just after finishing education, I went and worked with a subsidiary of Unilever and the Sultanate of Muscat, Oman, Muscat, for almost 18, 19 years. Those were the formative years. And the most important aspect that happened in my life was the entry of this lady called Vijaya, who's my wife now. She has been the single source of my inspiration, my guidance, and all the drive behind what I do today. So just after marriage, day in and day out in the Middle East, we would constantly think of coming back one day to India and do something. It used to happen every time we would come back on vacation, see the disparity between what was available in a Middle East country to what was not available to a lot of the disadvantaged families in India. Right. That is very stark. That's when we realized that someday we must come back and do something. And in the year 2019 and 20, Vijaya put her foot down and said, enough is enough. We just have a single daughter and she is young. We don't have to provide for a lot. Let's get back and start doing some community work. So that's how it started, Deepshika.
Wow, that's where your paradigm shift started.
Yes,
with your superwoman. That is so good.
And her insisting that I come back to India. And the good thing that happened to me was that we didn't get back to Bombay, we came to Bangalore. Bangalore, for some reason, is a far more easy city to do community work than a city like Bombay.
Okay.
So one thing, we were new to Bangalore. We had no experience in community work. We had no qualifications in community work, and we didn't know Kannada. And yet, in the last 20 years, we've done a decent amount of community work to a point where I can, you know, satisfactorily say that my quitting work and getting into social work full time has been worth the investment.
It is absolutely, because the guests the two guests prior to you, Madhumita and Simran, they speak so highly of you. I mean, we were discussing their bio and they ended up talking about you. And so we absolutely said that we must have you on this platform. It's an honor. So let's talk about how you went from there. You have, I'm not going to say it, you say it. You have a lot of children. Tell us about those.
Yes. Yes. So, Deepshika, when we came back to Bangalore, we knew that we wanted to work with children. And that's the easiest thing to do, no? Everybody who wants to get into community service wants to work with children. But we wanted to make sure that we were doing the right thing. So we went around, did some research in Bangalore. Bangalore has some excellent orphanages where children who do not have parents at all are, you know, brought up. But the orphan children, in some sense, are lucky. A lot of them get adopted and get good homes.
Okay.
There are also good homes in Bangalore for single-parent children, children of cancer-stricken, you know, AIDS-stricken, so on and so forth.
Okay.
20 years ago, the one area where NGOs were not willing to work on was homes, mostly the lower-income family homes, where the men, as soon as his wife delivers a girl child, is willing to throw her out of his home and start living with somebody else. This is very common, at least in the slums of Bangalore. I'm sure it must be so everywhere across India.
Yes,
so you have these young girls of 16 and 17 who are already a mother to a daughter, and the husband is not willing to keep her. Her own family, that is the parents, don't want her back because they live in very small homes. They have a brother who's already married and there is no place. Also, in a lot of us Indians, we believe that once we've got our daughters married off, we washed our hands off and we don't need a back anymore. So such young girls have no means of going to work with a little baby. She can't carry the baby to work. And when she goes to an NGO and asks the NGO to take care of the child, the standard answer an NGO then would give is that when both parents are alive, why should we take care of the child?
Oh.
On paper, it makes absolute sense, isn't it? Because when parents are alive, why should somebody else take care of the child? But on the ground, the situation is so starkly bad that the lady can't leave a child at home and go to work. So we decided to adopt only such girl children whose mothers had been abandoned because she had delivered a girl child. So in the year 2000, we adopted 15 girl children, all between the ages of 3, 4, and 5. And it was that crucial age that we wanted to bring them in so that we can get them into school and give them proper education. So I must tell you, Deepshika, 20 years down the line, three of my daughters are engineers. One is finishing a company secretaryship. One is a clinical psychologist. One is a professional dancer. Two work for HP. One works for DXC. Two work for call center. Three are mothers already, so on and so forth. So I have 16 smart young girls as our daughters. So that's the achievement from where we started. So in the first one and a half years, we were very busy getting our children into school. And for little children to be away from their own mothers is difficult. So unless we gave them all the love and affection of a new set of parents, they would not settle down. So the first one and a half years was a bit of a challenge. But once the children settled down, Deepshika, they would never ever go back to their mothers. During summer vacations, for us to make sure that the child remained bonded to her own biological mother, we would want to send the children back. But the children would refuse to go. That was a level of bonding. It continues to be so now. We are so closely associated with our children. In fact, in the next 2 days, one of our daughters is going to deliver a baby. And so we are so excited about it right now. That's how it is.
This is so beautiful. I mean, this gives me goosebumps, you know, the way you so proudly, you know, said this. I mean, this is amazing. I hope you didn't forget anybody because, you know, like even in two of my kids, there is like first child problems, second child problems. So they are going to give you a lot of grief if you miss out.
Yes, yes. But my daughters are darlings, as much as yours are. So they understand that he's an old man. He can be pardoned for his mistakes.
Okay, so you spoke at the TED Talks, and would you like to tell us that episode that brought tears to my eyes? I'm going to try and keep my makeup intact.
Right. So I'll just get back to you. Go back a few steps before I come to the TED Talks. So once my children were in school, Deepshika, between the time that they went to school, that was about 8:30 in the morning, and they came back at 4 in the evening, me and my wife, we had a lot of additional time. And since we had decided to be full-time social workers, we wanted to engage more with children. We started exploring opportunities, and within the neighborhood of where my children and we all were living, we located a government school. In Karnataka 20 years ago, things are a shade better now. Government schools did not have English education at all. It would either be a Kannada medium school or an Urdu medium school if they were Muslim children. In all instances, in spite of English being a subject in the syllabus, the education department was never able to provide them an English teacher. So we realized that after passing 10th standard, most government school children in Bangalore were simply unable to pick up a job, because in a city like Bangalore, if you don't speak English, I don't think you can find a job at all. Much more than Delhi, much more than Bombay, Bangalore is actually an English-speaking city. Generally, if you hire even a car driver, you will expect him to speak English. That's the city it is. So we realize that unless we impart English knowledge to these children, they will pass out of 10th standard, not being able to go to higher education because they don't know English, and all higher education is in English. And obviously, even if they finish with 10s and the parents now expect these kids to take up jobs, they will not find jobs, at least jobs that give them dignity. So we started English teaching in some of these schools. But in 6 months to 1 year's time, we realized that the kids were so excited. Slum kids were so keen on learning English that they wanted more of it. So we started to hire English teachers on our payroll. And now we have about 12 English teachers on our payroll. To every government school that we work with, we depute a full-time English teacher who's on Swabhiman's payroll, but teaches English in those schools. Through that Deepshika, in each of these schools, we found some very, very bright sparks. Children who with a little bit of help and support could do very well in life. So we used to pull those children out of government schools, move them to English medium private schools at our cost, that is the Swabhiman's cost. And a lot of these kids now have graduated and they hold very, very good jobs. So that's where the journey started. And the fifth or the sixth school, somebody told me that there is an Urdu school very close to where we live and they badly needed a school teacher there. Yeah. I went, did some research there, and I realized that that was an extremely poor locality where genuinely there was a need for an English teacher. So I located a community kid. One of the things that we normally do is pick up a local community mother or a male who has some bonding with the children in the community so that it's easier for him to be a teacher or her to be a teacher. So I found a boy who had just passed his 12th and was not doing anything, and I hired him as an English teacher. After he was hired, when I was talking to the mothers of these children, largely Muslim, all of them Muslim mothers because it was an Urdu school, every single mother told me, Deepshika, that after their husbands have gone to work and the children have gone to school, they have a lot of spare time in their hand. And if I could help them with some seed money, they would stay at home and generate income. That's when we decided to have an interest-free micro-lending program. We started lending small amounts of money, 5,000 and 10,000, to women in the community that I still didn't know very well then, about, say, 17 years ago. We started lending small amounts of money to these women, and we said, you go ahead and do business. So if I lend somebody a 10,000 rupees, every Sunday she's expected to come back and give me 500 rupees. So in 20 Sundays, she would have finished a loan, and then she would take a second loan and a third loan and fourth loan. There are women, Deepshika, who have taken 25, 30 cycles of loan now. There are almost 300 women who now take interest-free loans from us, all of them without a collateral, without a bank guarantee, without a signature, without no photograph, nothing. And trust me, all of them come back and pay the money, Deepshika.
So good.
If you want to invest, the best investment to do is invest on women in India. They are so honest, they're so hardworking. What we also realized, Deepshika, a little later in a year or two after the microfinance program started, was that wherever we gave money to women, we started to see children having better nutrition, children going to better schools, so on and so forth. So not that our money was coming back so that we could recycle it, but it was also that the families were growing. And vis-a-vis, we initially also started lending money to men. And we realized that that was a foolish thing to do because men don't return your money back at all. So we now only lend to women. And that's the program that started, 17 years ago and runs extremely well. The only set of women who don't give us a money back are the women who lose money in business, but that is understandable. The vagaries of these little business that they do, generally, they sell perishable items like vegetables, fruits. Agar sham tak wo nahi bika, to wo kharab ho jate hain, bichare, they start to lose money. Only in such cases, we write off the loans and we give them loans again. So that's been going on for a long time. When that was happening, we also realized that the community specifically, the community that I now work in, is a very large community. And most of them are daily wage laborers. These daily wage laborers, Deepshika, on a given day when he doesn't go to work, he or she doesn't go to work, they lose the income for the day. But even more importantly, they go to a private practitioner and spend at least 200 rupees to get himself symptomatically treated. So that is a huge amount of hit. It's a double whammy. And then he spends so much money on a doctor too. So we realized that if we could save that money for them, we could actually help the children with nourishment at home. And also in a poor man's home, because of poor ventilation, poor quality water supply, minimal nutrition and all that, the sickness actually keeps going around in the house. Pehle baap bimar girega, phir mother, maa giregi, phir bachche girenge. On an average, in a month, every poor family, even now, spends about 15-20% of their monthly income on medical needs. That's a criminal waste, isn't it?
Absolutely,
they could have used the money for much better things and hard-earned money at that.
Yeah.
So we decided to start charity clinics where we would provide quality, good treatment, home remedies, regular medicines too, free consultation and free medicines to people in the neighborhood. In 17 years' time, today we run three such charity clinics where between these three clinics, we have 100 people who attend on a daily basis. And all of them benefit. And the doctors that I have are so good, Deepshika, that my patients come to them and even discuss their family issues with them. They don't come just for medicines and health. They generally come and other things with the doctor. So that's the kind of bonding. And these clinics now have become the nucleus of the work that we do in the community. So it started with microfinance and then it moved to clinics. Then we also realized that there were private English medium schools in that community where there were similar parents, again poor, but who had some aspirations for their children. And they were sending, begging and borrowing to send their children to English medium schools, thinking that the English medium schools would emancipate their children from misery and poverty.
Right.
But they were very, very bright kids in such schools. So to make sure that these bright kids do not drop out, especially girl children, what happens, Deepshika, you would know this, in a family of, say, three children, if the two boys and a girl, and if the parent struggles to raise money for all the three children, the first thing he would do is pull out the girl child from the school.
Okay.
And normally it is a girl child who's the brightest of the three. So to make sure that we keep the girl children in school, but generally all bright children in school, about 15 years ago, we started a scholarship activity.
Okay.
So just before school start in the month of May and June, we make all the children in the community come and write tests with us. There's a small diagnostic test that we give. And the children who do well, anybody who scores about 60%, anything between 5,000 to 10,000 rupees a scholarship. That program supports about 300 children now. Among them, dozens have finished their education. They all have decent jobs. They now come back and work with me over the weekends because I ran a computer center there for the community. These youth come and run the computer center and train the next generation of kids. I run a library. These children read books for the younger generation kids, so on and so forth. I run a tuition center where these kids give free tuition in the evenings to the next generation kids. So when we started the education, especially the scholarship, Deepshika, we did not realize what we were getting into. But I have now realized that in a community which 20 years ago had no role models, today has a good 50 role models, young boys and girls who are doing so well that the neighbors and their children have started to believe that if these kids can succeed, my children and we can also succeed. So there is that paradigm shift that's happening in the community. More and more children want to study, more and more children want to come to school. So that is a sense of huge, sense of satisfaction that we get. So that happened. So that's where it all started. And then we realized that in that community, I can go on. Am I boring you?
No, please go on. I am loving it. I'm mesmerized.
Actually, it's looking like a monologue, so I thought.
No. I have only four questions. So that's okay. So you're already answering all of them. So it's okay. Please go on.
So when this was all happening, we also realized that in that community, there are a large number of senior citizens whose children have abandoned them. It's a slum of about 15,000 families, Deepshika. That's about 75,000 people by Bangalore standards, one of the largest slums, and the most impoverished too. So among 75,000 people, we realized that a good 1,000 senior citizens had no meals at home. They could not get food. Their children were not feeding them. The children themselves were poor, but a lot of poor people also take care of their elders, but a lot of them were not. So we had to feed them. But how do you cook for 1,000 people and feed them? No, it's not easy. And every time you face a challenge, I have seen Providence coming in the way and showing some light. So Bangalore has a lot of IT companies very close to where our slum is. They're at about 2 and 2:30 in the afternoon, Deepshika, after the executives in the company have eaten in their canteens, there is a lot of three-star quality food that is left over. And these companies, for sheer want of somebody to pick up the food and reach it to the poor, they just throw it away. It's either flushed down the drain or it's
Oh my
given to
God.
pigs, piggeries. Pigs eat them. So I approached, because there was a need for food and we didn't have the bandwidth to cook for 1,000 people, I approached one software company. And with some amount of coercing and conviction, they agreed. They also have challenges because a company that gives out food, if there is a consequence of bad food, the company's reputation is at stake. And these are multinationals, they would not let that happen. So I had to sign an MOU with the first company saying that agar kuch khane ke saath ho gaya, to Swabhiman and I personally will be responsible once they hand the food over to me. I was willing to take the risk because there was good quality food available. This is the three-star hotel food that you and I would pay 1,000 rupees to eat on a daily basis. So from one company, we started collecting food. 300 people's food from a company of about 1,000 employees. Utna khana roz ek ek software company mein waste hota hai. And then after 3 months, a second company signed up and a third company signed up. Between three companies, every single day, we were able to bring about 5 o'clock, 1,000 good meals and serve people. So that program went on exceptionally well for 6 years till the pandemic hit and all these software companies shut down. And now, even if they start 6 months, 1 year down the line, they will never have 100% capacity in their offices. They will only get in 25, 30% people. So that source of, free surplus food is gone forever. So that's one story. So that was happening. We also realized, Deepshika, that as we were feeding these 1,000 families, there is one level of families where young mothers with little children either widowed or the men have walked out on them or the men are absolute good for nothings. In 50% of families, not an exaggeration, the men are good for nothings. They don't earn, but even more importantly, they live off their wives' incomes. So in such homes, the mother, because of the limited resources that she has, there is very little nutrition at home. We can't give them cooked food because the mother is out at work and she comes back only at 6 and 7. We had to devise another program to take care of these children and these women. So we then decided to provide them groceries. So the program that started about 5 years ago with about 50 families now provides groceries, Deepshika, I'm not exaggerating, to 1,500 families every month. So 1,500 families have a small booklet that they bring. I sign on it for the month and they take 500 rupees of groceries. 500 rupees, 500 rupees worth of groceries is not a lot, but it takes care of 1 week of their ration at home. The mother will supplement by working hard and raising the rest of the money. But that program has been going on. So we did that. And then we started a computer center and then we started a library. We also do two other things that will interest you. There is a women empowerment program that we do. In that community, through the microfinance that we run, a large amount of women bought sewing machines because stitching comes very naturally to women. So at one point, after 6 or 7 years of lending, every third or fourth house had a sewing machine. And there isn't so much job in the community that all of them can earn. So we wanted to make sure that having invested on sewing machines, these women should have some income on a regular basis. Around that time, 5 or 6 years ago, the Bangalore Corporation banned the one-time use of plastic. We realized that there
Wow.
was an opportunity here to start stitching cloth bags. I believe
Wow.
Swabhiman must have been one of the first NGOs to start stitching cloth bags through women. Till the pandemic hit again, every single day, Deepshika, we were stitching about 2,500 to 3,000
Wow.
bags. Women were earning on an average, staying at home, 120 to 150 rupees. And that is a lot of money for
Yes.
a lower income family. So that
Right.
happens. Then we run a youth empowerment program too, where every Sunday, there are a good amount of college-going kids in the community. They go to college because they've done reasonably well in school.
Right.
But
Right.
because they come from the kind of backgrounds that they come, they may be okay with their knowledge on the subject, but their current affairs, their spoken English, their communications, all the soft skill that they should acquire to pick up a good job is generally missing. So we
Right.
now run a youth empowerment program where on every Sunday, we bring in about 45 to 50 of these college children and give them all these soft skills. There are children, and this program has been going on for 6 or 7 years now. Kids who have finished the soft skill program, have taken up jobs, now run the soft skill program themselves. The program that I used to run 6 or 7 years ago, I don't even go there now. But the job
Wow.
that these kids are doing is far better than what I can do or what I could ever have done. So the children who are now coming out of the soft skill program are far better, you know, empowered to pick up jobs. Just the other day, a girl picked up a job with Yes Bank and she's earning a 20,000 rupee salary, a BCom graduate.
Wow.
That's so heartening. There are other kids who are picking up jobs, you know, they're all moving on. And every time you give a child employment, an entire
Yeah.
family benefits, Deepshika.
Yeah.
The whole family's economic status goes up. So these are the few
Right.
things that Swabhiman does. And I suppose I've said
Few
enough.
things, just few things. These are just few things. This is a lot.
मैं सबसे जरूरी चीज आपको बोलना भूल गया. You wanted to understand about the TED Talk, no?
TED Talk, yes.
That is the most important, you know, thing about the whole program that Swabhiman does. Swabhiman is a completely slum volunteer driven program. Ek mere alawa, Deepshika and my wife, of course, nobody from Swabhiman or nobody in Swabhiman come from outside the slum. All our
Okay.
teachers, the doctors, of course, come from outside. But
Yeah.
all my employees, there are 40 of them, young kids, all between the ages of 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20, and a few women, they are so committed, they're so hardworking, they're so sincere. Their levels of integrity is amazing, Deepshika. पढ़े लिखे लोगों से आप इतना ज्यादा काम नहीं ले सकते हो. टू गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल, ड्यूरिंग द लॉकडाउन वी
Yeah.
वर सर्विंग 10,000 मील्स एवरी सिंगल डे. 10,000 मील्स इज अ ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ फूड. आप 10, 12, 15 शादियां कर सकते हैं. एंड इट वॉज
Absolutely.
लॉकडाउन, सो यू कुड नॉट मूव आउट ऑन द रोड्स. ऑफकोर्स वी हैड
Yeah.
पुलिस परमिशन फॉर अ व्हीकल, सो वी वर मूविंग आउट. बट टू कैरी फूड फ्रॉम डिफरेंट लोकेशंस एंड रीच इट टू नीडी पीपल on a daily basis for 3 full months. Even today, much after the, you know, lockdown is gone, the condition hasn't much changed for the poor people. Even today,
Right.
from morning till night, my boys serve 5,000 meals. They're all the time on their feet. मैंने आज तक किसी को पूछा नहीं उनको खाना मिल गया क्या. दे विल ऑलवेज पोस्ट पिक्चर्स एंड से सब यहाँ खाना दे दिया, यहाँ खाना दे दिया, यहाँ खाना दे दिया, यहाँ खाना दे दिया. इट्स सो
Wow.
एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी. आई हैव अ ग्रोसरी
Amazing.
गोडाउन. यस सॉरी दीपशिका, आई हैव अ ग्रोसरी गोडाउन वेर एट एनी गिवन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम वहां पे 4-5 लाख रुपए का ग्रोसरी है. एंड द की इज वन फैमिली, अ हस्बैंड एंड वाइफ, एक्सट्रीमली पुअर. दे आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर गिविंग आउट द ग्रोसरीज. आई कैन
Okay.
स्वेयर दैट वहां से एक दाना चावल का भी किसी ने लेके अपने घर नहीं गया होगा. दैट्स अ कमिटमेंट एंड द इंटेग्रिटी दैट पीपल हैव. सो स्वाभिमान इज अ कंप्लीटली स्लम वॉलंटियर ड्रिवन प्रोग्राम. That's why
Wow.
I suppose the basic secret of success for Swabhiman is that.
Beautiful.
Thanks.
Beautiful.
अब आप सवाल करें दीजिए.
So you were going to tell us about the marathon episode that you were talking about at the TED Talk. So that was like amazing. So would you like to
हाँ,
tell
that's
us
right.
about that?
Yes. So, around the same time, 2006, 2007, there were lots of these kids in the slums who were just idling. Children who
Yeah.
had finished education or half finished education. School dropouts bahut zyada rehte hain slums mein. My fear was, if I did not engage them in time, they could get into drugs and violence, theft and all that. that's how their life starts. Frustration sets in very quickly. So I got a few boys together and started to engage with them. पहले उनको मैंने थोड़ा सा इंग्लिश सिखाना शुरू किया. Then I also started engaging them in Swabhiman activities. So we had initially a team of 6 or 7 boys, all slum kids, all Muslim kids. And we were all illiterate. The leader of the pack, of course, was this young boy by name Suleiman. When this was happening, when I was just training these kids to be, you know, some kind of volunteering, there is this marathon program that TCS runs. It's a walkathon. It's a marathon. It's actually a run. Every year, TCS does it in Bangalore as much as they do it in Bombay, I think.
Stanchart does it. Other people do it.
Yeah. So when there are 25,000 people signed up for this run, after the run, they serve all of them breakfast. And only 10,000 people eat. So year after year, they were wasting 15,000 people's breakfast and they didn't know what to do with it. Somebody had heard that Swabhiman has the capacity. We had just then started to serve the food to these senior citizens. We were initially cooking 50 meals ourselves. Somebody had heard that Swabhiman could do that. So the people who ran the TCS event, they have an event manager. They called us up and said, can you take the food? And I asked them, how many meals? So they initially said the first that year was just about 6,000 additional meals. They said, 6,000 khana aap uthayenge subah 8 baje. And I told them flatly, no. I said, I just don't have the bandwidth to pick up 6,000 meals. It looked like a huge ask. And I came back and told these seven boys, I said, Suleiman, khadar aap uthayenge 6,000 khana? साहब ये क्या बात हो, आपने मना क्यों कर दिया उनको, हम उठाएंगे. बोला बच्चों सकता है ये बहुत बड़ा काम है. उनके जिद पे मैंने हाँ बोल दिया टीसीएस को. टीसीएस वाले भी मान गए. उस दिन रन हो गया 8:30 बजे. व्हेन वी वेंट इनटू द स्टेडियम वेयर द फूड वाज लेफ्ट ओवर, इट वाज नॉट 6,000 मील्स, इट वाज 9,000 मील्स. वी हैड इनिशियली प्लान फॉर 1 or 2 ट्रक्स, बट वी रियलाइज दैट वी विल रिक्वायर 4 or 5 ट्रक्स. एंड आई डिडंट हैव टू रीच इन डिफरेंट स्लम्स. तो मेरे लड़कों को मैंने बोला, देखो बच्चों गलती हो गई हमसे, इतना खाना हम बांट ही नहीं सकते. They said, सर आप हट जाओ, आप आराम से बैठो, हम बांट के आएंगे. ट्रस्ट मी दीपशिका, बाय 4 o'clock इन द इवनिंग दे हैड अरेंज फॉर एडिशनल ट्रक्स, एडिशनल हेल्प, टेकन द फूड, डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड, एंड द टीसीएस वॉलंटियर्स वेंट अलोंग विद देम एंड दे वर एस्टोनिश्ड टू सी दीस 7 किड्स एंड देयर फ्रेंड्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूट ऑल द ग्रोसरी, ऑल द फूड. दे वर सो इंप्रेस्ड. बट द नेक्स्ट ईयर द टीसीएस run happened, they of course called us back again for the food. By that time, I had confidence for the food, but TCS also generates a huge amount of publicity material. You know, those big flex screens, they put it across the city. How much do you know, Deepshika? Just for those 2 days event, 100,000 square feet of flex goes up across the city. And just after the event, the flex has no need. And by then, the Bangalore city had also banned the use of flex. But TCS had taken special permission saying that hum log use karenge, but we'll dispose it carefully. TCS called me up again and said, can you deal with flex? Hum log 100,000 flex upar se niche utar ke denge, aap usko le jayenge kya? Maine bola, flex ke sath hum kya karenge? We can't think of anything at all. Tab tak hamara silai ka kaam vagera shuru nahi hua tha.
Correct.
Again, Suleiman comes up and says, saab aap utha lo flex. Maine bola, Suleiman, 100,000 square feet ka aapko idea bhi hai kitna flex aayega? Saab aap uthao, main sambhal lunga. मैंने बोला करोगे क्या इसका? He saying बारिश का टाइम है साहब. They always have this run in the month of May and June. बारिश का टाइम है, हम रोड में जो सोते हैं उनके लिए छत बनाएंगे इसका. I thought what a genius this guy is. I said anyway उठा लेंगे. And you know we took the chance. Trust me, in two and a half days they ripped all the flex from the banners, brought it to the community. And TCS का एक शर्त था, the advertisements on the flex should not be visible, which means if there are two flexes, the ad should be inside and the outside should be the white side. So we had to put them together and stitch them or glue them. So we started gluing them. 100,000 square feet of flex, they arranged for women to come and glue it. In 10 days time, we had distributed as many flex banners as, you know, roofs for homeless in Bangalore.
Amazing.
And I realized that these kids were teaching me a few things. I am a marketing man all my life, and I didn't know that there are things that I can't do that these kids can do. Then from one thing to the other, then TCS started calling us to Bombay. Bombay is a much bigger event. And we had a team of 10 people here. Bombay, Suleiman and Ganesh Mania physically challenged people. Just two of them went there. एंड दे पिक्ड अप लोकल पीपल फ्रॉम देयर, उनसे ये सारा काम करवाया, बॉम्बे में बांट के आ गए. And they had never been to Bombay. The next time, Suleiman, we get a call from Calcutta. Ganesh Mani was unwell. Suleiman says, मैं अकेले जाऊंगा. मैंने बोला, सुलेमान पागल हो, कलकत्ता में ना आपको जबान आती है, बॉम्बे में तो हिंदी चल जाएगी, कलकत्ता में बंगाली है, आप लोगों को नहीं जानते. साहब आप छोड़ो ना, मेरे को प्लेन टिकट लेके दो, मैं जाके आ जाऊंगा. So the incentive for Suleiman was a plane travel. अकेले को मैंने प्लेन में चढ़ाया. आप मानेंगे दीक्षिका, आज भी टीसीएस वाले मेरे को फोन करके पूछते हैं कि लड़के ने अकेले ये काम किया कैसे.
Wow.
The kind of volunteers that I have, extraordinary. They tire me out saying कि साहब अब क्या करना है, अब क्या करना है, अब क्या करना है. There is no Sunday that I can relax. There is no weekend that I can relax. There is no Eid. There is no Diwali. There is no Holi for me. They will not let me relax. That's the level of commitment these kids have. And what I have now realized, Deepshika, what drives them is that in that community, they are now looked upon with a lot of respect. And people like Suleiman, there's adulation. When, you know, the other people look at them, all their needs, they go to Suleiman now. Suleiman, हमारे बच्चे को स्कूल में भर्ती करा दो. खादर, हमारे बच्चे को हॉस्पिटल लेके जाओ. हमारे बच्चे के लिए थोड़ा सा राशन दे दो. So these people are suddenly feeling very empowered, and that empowerment has become a nasha for them.
Beautiful. You know, while you're telling me all this, you know, Venkat, I'm like just saying that apne itna sara achieve kiya, you should actually have some kind of a course or some kind of this thing, you know, where you actually educate people on how to start this, because this is amazing. Like, a normal thing, like how do you set up a trust, how do you get to this, like right now my brain is already thinking that we have like a big underprivileged housing areas here and all that, and I'm already thinking, are there doctors, are there, you know, are there teachers, are there like you said, English speaking teachers, you know, do they have things, you know, all those kind of things, how does one get in there, because like abhi tak we have, you know, that in mind, you know, like a Bollywood movie that you will try to get in, there's already a local person there trying to be you know, like a goon.
Difficult
or whatever
for you.
You
yes,
know, how do you achieve that and all that. So I think Venkat sir, what you need to do is, now you need to start now, aapne abhi wahan pe sab training kar di, now you need to train people like us. How we
and
should
charge
penetrate
you.
That? Yeah, charge us absolutely, and you should.
No.
But this is how it should be. That you should train people like us to actually penetrate through here and start helping, because you know the minute that, you know, wo jo, the thing that I look for in these interviews is that one moment. And you had that moment, but then to, you know, go into and then to realize ki acha doctor ka problem, fir teacher ka problem, fir iska problem, soft skill ka problem. Yeah. It is amazing. It is amazing. So you've already spoken about all the things that you've done. Tell us about the real challenges or obstacles that you might have faced during, you know, your journey. But before that, one second, I want to just read out. There's Simran who's saying, so nice to see you, Venkat. Lots of love and respect for the work you do. Madhumita says, Venkat sir, you're a true inspiration. God bless you for your selfless work, impactful work. Suleiman,
love you both. Huh?
Yeah.
Madhumita and Simran both know Suleiman very well.
Yeah, so she's written that Suleiman is a rock star. Truly, Venkat sir, his commitment at such a young age is commendable. Every interaction with him has been such a pleasure. That is so good. I mean, you have trained somebody to, you know, go and help his kind and his people, which is so good, you know.
True.
So let's talk about the challenges and obstacles. That is something that I think all of us get scared and, you know, don't get out of our comfort zone.
True. So, the challenges came initially when we were when we decided to adopt children. So, you know, bringing up girl children is a huge challenge. You are taking responsibility for lives. Everything that you do, running a school, running a clinic, is a morning till evening or an evening till night affair. At some
Right.
point, you shut yourself off and you come home. But when you
Yeah.
bring up children in your own home or in the home that you bring up these kids in, it's a 24/7 activity. If all goes well, people will say, well done. God forbid if one thing goes wrong, especially with a girl child, no, Deepshika, all
Yes.
hell can come loose. So that
Yes.
was one fear that was at the heart of our, thing to start with. And yet we took courage and started. But when I started it at home, my own people said, Venkat, don't get into this. This is too
Yes.
much of an involvement. Also, because that was our first endeavor and we had no experience in bringing up children. It's not
Right.
easy. We didn't know
Yes.
Kannada, we didn't know Telugu. A lot of these children were Telugu and Kannada. And from what kind of backgrounds we didn't know. It was not easy. So that was the first challenge that we faced. So when we had the first child, we realized that it's not so difficult. When we got in second child, we realized that again it's not difficult. So in just 1 year's time, we had 15 and we realized that it was all pleasure. Because
Oh.
once you have a good number of children, no, they all become company for each other. You don't really have to mu do much. What you must do is make sure that you give them a lot of love and affection, which they may not have got from their parents. The father surely never gave it to them. The mothers, even if she wanted to, because of the kind of life that she leads, she can't give it to them. So
Yes.
that was it. So very quickly the challenge changed into pleasure. Otherwise, in the
Right.
last 20 years, my only challenge has been to raise funds. But
Okay.
even that in a city in Bangalore is not very difficult. The moment people
Okay.
see good work being done,
Yeah.
funds do flow in. I haven't had very many challenges, Deepshika. I have to actually seriously
Okay.
think now. सोच के आपको बताना पड़ेगा कुछ है क्या. बहुत ज्यादा नहीं थे एक्चुअली, है नहीं अभी भी.
अच्छा है ना, अच्छा है, नहीं है तो अच्छा है
हाँ
ना,
बिल्कुल, वेरी
गुड.
वेरी वेरी
Why do you want challenges? I mean obstacles.
नाइस. हाँ
What you're doing is a challenge. I mean that is a challenge, but why should you want फालतू का obstacles? That is
हाँ
beautiful.
अननेसेसरी, ट्रू, नथिंग, नॉट मच
Yes.
एट ऑल. ऑल्सो बिकॉज
Very
दीज
good.
ऑब्स्टेकल्स आर वेरी क्विकली टर्न इनटू अपॉर्चुनिटीज, एंड फ्रॉम अपॉर्चुनिटीज दे हैव टर्न इनटू समथिंग दैट हैज रीप्ड रिवॉर्ड्स. वी डोंट इवन थिंक ऑफ देम नाउ लुकिंग बैक एज चैलेंजेस.
Beautiful. Beautiful. So, what is the impact of what you've already done? You've already actually named the impact that you have raised, inspirational people who are, helping their own. But if you want to just sum it up into what is the impact of the work, the paradigm shift that you did?
So for me, the most powerful impact that I've had is the women who now are able to take care of their families because of the incomes that they have on a regular basis. When women earn, like I told you earlier, an entire family benefits. So there are
Right.
about 300 women who are able to take care of their families because of the lending that we do. They do all
Right.
kinds of small businesses, but they do it and make sure that the last penny that they earn goes towards the well-being of their children. That's a huge impact for me. Equally
Right.
big is the fact that there are a good number of children in that community who are now holding very responsible jobs and who come back and work with me. The other impact is a volunteer team that I have who are all leaders in their own caliber. Suleiman, I just named one. There are seven others like him. I mean, not just
Wow.
like Suleiman, but they can all follow Suleiman and be Suleiman someday. So that's the kind of impact that we've had in the community, but not because of our efforts. These women are extraordinary. They wanted to succeed. The school children wanted to succeed, those say they succeeded. My volunteers wanted to succeed, they succeeded. Swabhiman was incidentally there as a part of their journey. So the impact is largely all these three. Otherwise, of course, we've
Wow.
taught computers to children, we've fed people. Yeah,
Beautiful.
these needs to be done because for somebody to
Yes.
survive for a tomorrow, you need to feed them today. But having fed them today, what next, isn't it? You can't keep feeding
Yeah.
somebody for life. You must make
Yeah.
them start to learn to fish on their own. That is
Yeah.
happening ever so slowly, but it's surely happening. So
Beautiful.
these are the three, four impacts in the community.
Beautiful. And does Swabhiman accept donations?
Deepshika, all the time, the more the better. Because we are
Good.
all the time thinking of new programs. Every
Right.
single day, something or the other new comes up. So the food
Right.
distribution that I was saying, what happens now is that we serve food in the communities. We also know that there are some public spaces in Bangalore. There is a very fairly large church called Infant Jesus Church. Simran and Madhumita would know. The church has a huge number of visitors on Thursdays and Sundays. There are lots of poor people who come there. Similarly, the Bangalore railway station, the Majestic bus station, a large number of transiting poor people have no food to eat. We have just the other day got a bus, not a bus, a small van, Piaggio Ape. We are going to be daily cooking food, 500 people's food, take it about 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, and they can park in one of these locations and serve freshly cooked food to all these people who are transiting that area. So that's a new project that was to have started on the 1st of April, but got slightly delayed. 15th, we should launch that. So for cooking 500 meals, even at the average of about 15 rupees a meal, I need 7,500 rupees every single day. So funds are required. Then, Deepshika, there are hundreds and hundreds of children out of school this year because the parents have lost their livelihoods. The parents haven't paid rent for their homes. In many, many homes that I know, the electricity supply has been disconnected because they haven't paid their electricity bills. And there is not enough for the children at home to eat. So we need to get many of these children into schools. Schools cannot give them free education because the teacher's salaries have to be paid. There is a, you know, running cost of the school. Schools have reduced the fee, and even that the parents are not able to pay. And such children are out of school. And a lot of children, what the parents now do, Deepshika, is their priority now is not education. Their priority is survival. ऐसे में क्या करते हैं, अपने बच्चों को कोई छोटे छोटे काम पे लगा देते हैं. कोई प्लम्बर के साथ भेज दिया, कोई पंक्चर की दुकान पे भेज दिया, कोई बाप के साथ सब्जी बेचने को भेज दिया. जो लड़के एक बार स्कूल से हटके कमाना शुरू कर दिया ना, इफ अ चाइल्ड स्टार्ट्स टू अर्न इवन 500 रुपीस अ डे, सॉरी 50 रुपीस अ डे, द चाइल्ड विल नेवर एवर कम बैक टू स्कूल, बिकॉज़ वो बच्चे को पैसे का चस्का लग गया. सो वी वॉन्ट टू मेक श्योर दैट सच चिल्ड्रेन रिमेन इन स्कूल. सो आई नीड मनी फॉर स्कॉलरशिप्स ऑल्सो. सो Madhumita and Simran, they're online. They have done a lot for me through the pandemic and even before that, and continuing to do so. I must take this opportunity to thank both of them. God bless them and many, many more like them.
So sweet. Yeah, they're absolutely wonderful human beings. So why I asked this question was so that everybody that is watching from the Paradigm Shift can, you know, we will be putting the donation, you know, we will be putting the links to Swabhiman's website where all the banking details and everything is there. So any donations are welcome. So you can be, you can go directly on Swabhiman's site and do that. And everybody that is watching from Venkatji's side and this, please join, please follow our page called the paradigmshift.co on Facebook or and Instagram. We cover inspiring, beautiful stories like Venkat and the commendable work that they're doing, and this is like amazing. I mean, like aapka, you know, like I said, that course you have to design, like the way you've so smoothly transitioned into, you know, ye bhi karna, ye bhi karna, ye bhi karna, ye bhi karna is beautiful. So I will be talking to you after and eating your brains if you have the time for you.
Seriously, I must help scale this program. Otherwise, we'll remain a one-slum wonder, isn't it? The whole idea is to in so many more places. Very much, yes.
Yeah.
Anybody who's interested in learning, I can, you know, starting is the beginning, difficult part. Beginning is a difficult part.
Yes.
So I can help them start off these little initiatives and they will themselves find their own levels and scale it on their own.
Beautiful. That is beautiful. And so any last messages, Madhumita says, thank you, sir. She's there. Okay. So any message for our viewers so that then we can wrap this up?
Message main kaun hota hu dene wala, Deepshika, mujhe samajh mein nahi aata hai. Just that all the people watching this are very good people. एक ये है कि आई बिलीव दैट इफ ईच वन ऑफ अस कैन होल्ड वन हैंड यू नो आर ओन मेड्स चिल्ड्रेन आर ओन सिक्योरिटी गार्ड्स चिल्ड्रेन एंड मेक श्योर दैट दीस चिल्ड्रेन एजुकेट इंडिया विल बी अ फार बेटर प्लेस ऑल ऑफ अस हैव टू डू ओनली टू थिंग्स एजुकेट टू चिल्ड्रेन दैट वी नो फ्रॉम अ डिसएडवांटेज फैमिली जनरली इन आवर ओन होम्स यू विल फाइंड समबडी आर ओन मेड्स आर ओन सिक्योरिटी गार्ड्स आर ओन ड्राइवर्स इफ वी गारंटी देयर एजुकेशन I'm sure that next generation, they will not remain drivers and security guards. We may not find maids very easily 10 years from today, But that's the
But that's
least of our
okay.
problems. That's
Yes.
perfectly okay.
Yes.
That's the
Absolutely.
message.
So beautifully said. That is very, 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 very well put. Because I remember when we started long time ago, my husband Sanjeev wanted to help, and then the first thing he did was that he pays a part of the fees of all his employees, which is
Oh,
about 30 to
beautiful.
40 people. So he's doing a wonderful job. So in a very small way, in the easiest
Yes.
way possible. But like you said, that I have to be almost like, I'm thinking in my head, I have to be almost like Rajinikanth to go into the slums and actually accomplish what you did. So we have to get your course online.
Hoga. Where there is a will, there are many ways. Aram se hoga. Done.
So good.
Someday I will interview you sitting in the slums, and you will be the, you know, guest on the paradigm shift. Hoga na?
Absolutely, why
right.
not?
Very
we will have
nice.
A Swadhiman Mumbai.
That's right. Okay, branch.
That is so
great.
Good. So thank you so
Thanks.
much. It's been an honor.
Bless you.
And you know, thank
Absolutely.
You for you know taking your time.
Thanks.
And shat shat pranam to your superwoman wife, who has actually you know pulled you out and got you to do this and has been by your side all this time. Thank you so
True.
Much.
Thanks. God bless you. God bless everyone who's watching this. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye. Bye.